right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Rami Batal, the CEO of Universal Ibogaine. And Dr. Batal, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Morning, Steve. I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Very exciting day for the company. You're officially trading now on the TSX Venture under the ticker IBO. We'll talk a bit about the company in a second, but just sort of the getting to this particular point that you're now a trading company, it must be very exciting for you and the team.
Indeed. It was quite the journey. We're very excited. This is the first TSXV company with the Ibogaine name and the Ibogaine focus in it and on it. We're happy to be here. It's a fundamental play as much as it is a play in the world of psychoactive medicines and psychedelics. In this transaction, to get us to be public, we've acquired a clinic that treats patients with addiction. So that's very solid for us, very exciting. We have, of course, merged with PSQ. That was this three-pronged the sort of approach was the road to us becoming or going on the TSX. So we're very excited to be here now in the TSXV, and we're looking forward to a bright future for this company.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people are going to be looking at the company now that you're trading live. So just give people a bit of a sort of a look into what Universal Ibogaine is all about from the start to where you are now.
Happy to do so. So we are in the addiction space, much wanting and a lot of unmet medical needs that we're trying to address. Central to our thesis, to our approach to addiction, is going to be the role of Ibogaine as a psychoactive medicine that is an addiction disruptor that works like no other that we have seen. But we're not limiting our focus to Ibogaine. We're starting with it. We're making it central to a disease management system for addiction that would start with the Ibogaine, but not end there. We are a biotech company in a way, in terms of our development program of Ibogaine to make it medicalized here in Canada under the watchful eye of Health Canada and then elsewhere ultimately. And at the same time, we are treating addiction with the state-of-the-art innovative model that we have pre-Ibogaine and through Ibogaine when it becomes medicalized.
Yeah. Is that going to be a big push, especially with what we've seen of the opioid crisis literally around the world? Is this something people should be looking at as potentially helping get people the help they need without putting them into the situation where they're addicted to opioids?
Certainly invite people, future investors, to look at us not only as a platform to do well, but also to do good. We are addressing the opioids crisis head on, given the established success empirically in other jurisdictions of Ibogaine as a medicine for opioid use disorder, the formal name for opioid addiction. Ibogaine by no means is limited to opioids. We do have great potential in other addictions that have been with us for a long time beyond the sort of crisis description of opioid addiction. Alcoholism, as an example, there's potential for cocaine and other stimulants. So it's broad and we're going to start somewhere, but we're going to maximize its potential as we go.
Yeah. Obviously, you've got a lot of things you want to do over the next 6 to 12 months. Can you give us sort of a bit of an idea of what we could expect out of the company?
Perfect. The road to make Ibogaine accessible to our Canadian patients and our physicians has to go through Health Canada. We are looking at a clinical development program that would take Ibogaine to a point whereby Health Canada feels comfortable that all these data and evidence that have been generated in other jurisdictions are compatible with our standards as a G7 country, as a reputed regulator. And we're going to conduct these trials as soon as we get the authorization from Health Canada to do so. Our large expected trial is what we call a human proof of concept study that would show safety and efficacy. This is going to be the inflection point in terms of the place of Ibogaine in our medical system for addiction. And at the same time, we're, of course, starting to treat addiction using whatever innovative methods are allowable and authorized starting today. So just so that it's not lost to our investors that we are now owners of a clinic out of the greater Winnipeg area in Manitoba. This clinic does see patients, been seeing patients for years. We're going to start treating these patients, introducing new modalities in terms of the treatment. And ultimately, we will merge the two models as we grow and expand into other clinics and as Ibogaine and other psychoactive substances become medicalized for addiction.
Yeah. And lastly, Dr. Batal, as I mentioned, you're trading on the TSX Venture now under the ticker IBO. What would you what would the message you like to send to people who are looking at the company potentially for investment?
I'm going to finish where I started, Steve. This is an opportunity to do well because we are in a very active field at a time whereby psychedelics are coming back to be hopefully part of the mainstream approach to mental health and addiction. It's an opportunity, of course, to do good. We know the size and the complexity of the problem at hand. We want to address that. It's a social investment as much as it is about making money and generating wealth.
All right. Well, Dr. Patel, congratulations once again, and great to see you again. Thank you.
Appreciate the time, Steve. Thank you. All the best to you.
All right. All the best to you as well. Dr. Rami Batal, the CEO of Universal Ibogaine, now trading on the TSX Venture under the ticker IBO.